好的，好，把昆特之音服务源于聆听，各位尊敬的奉献者，早上好，今天是2024年7月8日，我们又荣幸的邀请到了圣巴提维努纳什纳辛马尔总讲今天的大佛教海堂甘露早课，请聆听哈瑞克什纳。
ॐ ज्ञानतिमरञ्जस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः पञ्चकौपतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितनां पवानेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदे गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे So we're hearing about the travels of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan. And by the power of the mantra from his guru, he was able to enter into the Vaikuntha planets. So he got into Vaikuntha and he was able to meet with the Lord of the universe. Lord Narayan personally met with him and he's talking with him. And Lord Narayan told him, he said that You know, I, he said, he told Gop Kumar, he said, I met you in Govardhan. And at that time, I became your guru. And my name was Jayanta. So today you fulfilled my desire. You have come here. I said, this is my happiness. He said, I want you to stay here forever. Lord Narayan is being very humble. He's saying to Gop Kumar, he said, I have not done any good for you, but you have done a lot of good for me. Yeah, because you have come here, so this was the greatest thing I could hope for.
因为你来这里了。 这是我可以指望的你最了不起的事情，最棒的一件事。So
Lord Narayan is hoping that Gop Kumar will forget all the troubles which he had to go through to come there.
主拿人呢，希望Gopa Kumar忘记他来这里所经历的种种麻烦。
And the Lord is hoping that now that he's come to Vaikuntha, that he will stay here.
主希望既然他已经来到了昆塔，他就可以留在这里。So
Gop Kumar said he's been drinking. He said he's become intoxicated by drinking. The beverage of the words of the Supreme Lord.
Gopa Kumar 说, 他因为喝饮了至尊主 至尊主甘露般的话语而感到陶醉。
Gopkumar said he was so bewildered he was not able to say anything, and he was not able to understand or to do anything.
古帕库马尔他感到困惑，他没有说一句话，他没能赞美主，他不明白，他也什么也做不了。
But just at that time, a number of other people appeared in front of them, and they were all playing the flute. And they were dressed as cowherd boys like him.
就在那时，有几个人来到了他们面前，他们吹着笛子，穿着就像他一样的牧牛童的衣服。
So when they saw Gopkumar, then when they saw that he was also dressed like a cowherd boy, and he also had a flute, then they encouraged him, and they pulled him into the middle of their association, and they urged him to also play on his flute.
他们就把古帕库尔拽到了他们中间，鼓励他也吹笛子。然后跟他们一起联谊。
So Gopkumar took his flute up and he began to play, and he played in all the different styles which he knows from Govardhan.
于是 Gopkumar 就手拿笛子就吹起了他在 Govardhan 山所熟悉的各种曲调的笛子。
The bamboo flute was actually from Govardhan. It was bamboo which grew on the Govardhan hill.
他手里的这根笛子实际上是来生长在 Govardhan 山的竹子做的笛子。
So Gopkumar, he was expert in playing the flute, and he satisfied all the people by his flute playing.
Gopkumar 非常擅长吹笛子，他通过吹笛子就满足了祈愿的所有的人。
Yeah, it was Lord Madhava was there, and there was also all of his associates.
在场的有、
so、they were all happy with his flute playing.
主 Madhava 在那里，他的所有的同友也在那里，他们对 Gopkumar 的吹的笛子非常满意。
So Gopkumar was holding his flute in his hands, even when he was giving instructions to his student in Boma Vrindavan, still he would always hold his flute in his hand.
Gopkumar 手持竹笛，他虽然是在 Boma Vrindavan 教导着自己的学生，他也一边教导学生，一边手持竹笛。
So because the flute was coming from the Govardhan Hill, so it was an ordinary flute. It was actually a spiritual flute.
这根竹笛可不是普通的笛子，它实际上是一根灵性的竹笛。
And Gop Kumar is coming from, his home is also in Govardhan. So Govardhan is very dear to Gop Kumar.
Gopal Kumar 实际上是从他在 Govardhan 山的家来到这里的，他非常钟爱 Govardhan。
And so when Lord Krishna is pleased, then we understand that Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, is also pleased.
一旦主 Krishna 感到满意，我们就可以推明白 Lakshmi 幸运女神也很满意。
Lord Narayan is always complete, full of knowledge. He knows all the different arts, like playing the flute, dancing, everything. He knows all these arts.
主 Narayan 呢，他是完整的，既完美又完整的，所以他拥有一切知识，包括他了解所有的艺术。他也知道该如何吹笛子，也知道舞蹈的艺术。
So he's also a reservoir of mercy.
他实际上是仁慈的储藏库。
And he showed that mercy by he allowed other people to entertain him. So the Lord was satisfied when Gop Kumar played on the flute.
Gopal Kumar 吹笛子，令主感到非常满意。
And when Gop Kumar stopped playing, then everyone requested everyone they were requested by Lakshmi Devi. Everyone wanted to leave. But the devotees, they had to persuade Gop Kumar, that they had to persuade him. They had to persuade him not to go.
So, 当 Gopal Kumar 停止吹笛子之后，所有人这时候就想离Lakshmi Devi 就请求大家离开，所有人都想离开，奉献者劝说了 Gopal Kumar 不要离开。
So the devotees had to persuade Gop Kumar to let them escort, they had to escort Gop Kumar outside because he didn't want to stop playing.
奉献者就劝说 Gopal Kumar 允许他们来陪同 Gopal Kumar 去外面，因为 Gopal Kumar 不想停止吹笛子。
So Lakshmi told the devotees to leave because it was getting time for Lord Narayan's lunch.
Lakshmi 就告诉奉献者要离开现场，因为该到了主 Narayana 吃午餐的时刻了。
So, if she was the only one remaining.
Lakshmi 女神是唯一留下来的人。
During the, when the Lord takes his meal, usually she's the one to be there, the only one who's allowed to be there.
通常当主进餐的时候 ，Lakshmi 是唯一被允许留在那里的。
It said just like a housewife, she will always want to serve her food to her husband. So Lakshmi shows her opulence to provide comfort for Lord Narayan and Vaikuntha. That's the pleasure, that's her desire, that's what gives her pleasure.
就像家庭主妇会伺候自己的丈夫，同样 Lakshmi 也充满着富裕，他想给主 Narayan 提供舒适，在 Vaikuntha 为主 Narayan 提供舒适，所以他有这种愿望，这给他带来快乐。
So Lord Gopkumar said when he was in Vaikuntha, he was given the chance to get all kinds of opulences, but he avoided them.
Gopal Kumar 说，当他在 Vaikuntha 的时候，他就有机会拥有所有各式各样的富裕，但是他本人避免了这些富裕。
Gopkumar, he didn't like to even show any interest in any of these things.
Gopal Kumar 甚至不想对这些事物展示出丝毫的兴趣。
Is it your turn or my turn?
Hare Krishna?
Haribol?
It's your turn, Maharaj.
Okay. So Gopkumar said he refused to take any interest in any of the opulences of Vaikuntha that were offered to him.
Gopal Kumar 说，他就拒绝对在 Vaikuntha 被提供给他的各式各样的富裕展示出任何的兴趣。
And he said also, Gopkumar said he stayed in that same form as a cowherd boy. He didn't give up that form.
而且 Gopal Kumar 他仍然保持着一位牧牛童的形象。他没有放弃作为牧牛童的形象。
你想申请他的要求？
喂
？Haribo。Yes, Maharaj.
Okay.So because he was used to living in Vaikuntha, special powers were given to him. But he didn't like to use them.
因为 Gopal Kumar 此时此刻是在无忧星宿 Vaikuntha, 所以他就被赐赋予了被提供了特殊的力量，但是他不想使用这些力量。
In Vaikuntha, All the opulences are spiritual, and they're full in eternity, knowledge, and bliss.
塞外昆塔，所有的富裕是灵性的，它们充满着永恒知识和极乐。
And they submit themselves to the control of the people around them.
这些富裕，他们就屈从，他们就主动的愿意服从那些在他们周围的这些人的控制之下。
And they appear whenever a person just desires them.
任何人只要想拥有这些富裕，这些富裕就立刻会显现那里。
Everything in the spiritual world is full of, is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
在灵性世界，一切都是永恒的，充满着知识和极乐。
But the use of opulence depends on the desire of the people.
但是使用这些富裕是取决于，取决于人们的愿望。
A person may have individual powers. A person may have powers, but these powers are not material, they're spiritual.
一个人可能会拥有力量，但 这种力量却不是物质的，而是灵性的力量。
And the people who are using them, they will use them without any fault, without any selfish intentions.
而使用这些力量的人，他们也都是不会犯错误的，他们也没有自私的动机。
They won't use them for their sense gratification.
他们不会把这些富裕用于个人的感官享乐。
They'll only use them in their devotional service.
他们只会用这些富裕从事奉献服务。
So we see that there's opulence, even in something which seems like absence. There's opulence, even though it appears like there's nothing, but there's opulence.
虽然，看上去是，虽然是看不见的，看上去好像是没有什么。但实际上，这些富裕就在那里。
When the opulence is visible, the devotees still feel as if they don't possess anything.
而当这些富裕可以被看见的时候，奉献者的感觉。感受是他们好像是不拥有任何事物。
So this is the special nature of Vaikuntha.
这就是无忧星宿的特殊的本质。
So everyone who lives in Vaikuntha has the opportunity to control these different powers, these different opulences.
在百昆塔，人人都有机会控制不同的力量和富裕。
Yeah, they can use it. They may want to show it to others. They may want to just hide it.
他 他们也许可以向别人展示，也许他们可以把这些力量赋予都隐藏起来。
But even when devotees and Vaikuntha use their ability to show wonderful things, they still feel very humble and meek.
即便是百昆特的人们运用了这些富裕和力量，他们可以向别人展示这些，但是他们仍然是感觉到自己感觉非常谦卑温顺。
Because they always remember that they're just spark, a little spark of the Supreme.
因为他们永远记得自己只是至尊主的非常微小的一个火花。
And that little, this sparks, they all come from the Satchit Ananda opulence of Vaikuntha.
这些微小的火花都是来自于Vaikuntha的永恒知识极乐的富裕。
So devotees in Vaikuntha, they're free from any tendency to exploit other people.
Vaikuntha 的奉献者，他们摆脱了剥削其他人的倾向。
They never think about their own selfish interests.
他们永远不会想考虑自己的自私的兴趣利益。
So this is the nature of Vaikuntha.
这就是无忧心素的本质。
Yeah, it's free from all the anxiety of the material life.
他没有物质生活的种种焦虑。
So in that place, all the spiritual nature exists with so much variety, all different ways in which to serve the Supreme Lord.
在那个地方，灵性的本质呢是丰富多彩的，他们展示出种种服务至尊主的种种方式。
So Gopkumar said, because of his previous practice, he continued to pay attention to his worship of the Supreme Lord.
Gopkumar 说，由于他以前的修行，他继续不断的留意要去崇拜至尊主。
So Gopkumar paid a lot of attention to his worship of the Supreme Lord and just behaved like an insignificant devotee.
Gopkumar 就非常小心的留心要去崇拜至尊主，他的行为就好像他是一个微不足道的奉献者。
So Gopkumar, he could have become proud, thinking himself equal in quality with Lord Narayan, because Lord Narayan had personally spoken to him.
Gopkumar 本来 可以变得很骄傲，觉得他现在可以和主拿热呢并驾齐驱了，因为主亲自和他谈话了。
But Gop Kumar preferred to remain humble. He knew it was an advantage to be humble.
Gopa Kumar 宁愿保持谦卑，因为他知道保持谦卑是很有优势的。
He was always convinced that the only real happiness was in satisfying the Lord.
他总是确信真正的快乐只有当能够满足主的时候才会获得真正的快乐。
So from the beginning of his practice, he'd always been humble.
从他一开始修行的时候，他就总是保持谦卑。
He didn't try to put on a show that he was a big devotee.
他不想炫耀，他是一个伟大的奉献者。
And among all the devotees in Vaikuntha, he had a special karma, a special destiny. So he had to follow his nature.
在百昆纳的所有奉献者，他们都有一种特殊的命运，他们都遵循着自己的本性。
Gop Kumar says, in his heart, he understood that by the mercy of the Lord, he had gained the real fruit.
戈帕库马尔心里十分清楚，急着主的仁慈，他已经获得了真正的果实。
So by the mercy of the Lord, he'd got the real fruit, the fruit which came from all his previous births and endeavors.
多帕库马尔明白，由于主的仁慈，他已经因为他前世的许多事的修行和努力，他获得了，他已经得到了真正的果实。
So Gop Kumar had been describing about what had happened to him before and what he had done in Vaikuntha.
Gopa Kumar 就这样形容了在之前所发生的事情，以及他在 Vaikuntha 上 Vaikuntha 无忧星宿的所作所为。
So he's giving an indication about what is actually going on in his mind.
他也暗示了他内心的想法。
He'd been thinking that he had actually achieved the complete perfection of his life.
他一直在想，他现在已经实现了生命的完美。
So Gop Kumar thought, oh, what great happiness this is. What an exalted place this Vaikuntha is. And Lord Narayan is so wonderful.
Gopa Kumar 就想， 他获得了多么伟大的了不起的快乐，而瓦昆塔这个地方是多么崇高的地方，主哪日呢是多么奇妙啊。
And his mercy is even more wonderful.
他的仁慈甚至更为奇妙。
So Gop Kumar wants to tell us that he has understood these wonders directly.
Gopa Kumar 告诉我们，他直截了当呢就明白了这些奇迹。
But he doesn't want to show all this to everyone.
但是他不想向每一个人来表明展示这一切。
He doesn't want to show everyone how astonished he is also.
他也不想向别人表明他内心的惊讶。
The glories of Vaikuntha cannot be compared with anything else.
Vaikuntha 的荣耀是任何事物都无可比拟的。
So to people who have to see, for people who have to see, they have not yet seen Vaikuntha, there's very little we can tell them about it.
对于那些没有见过 Vaikuntha 无忧心宿的人们，我们可以告诉他们的是少之又少。
So even after some time, by the kindness of the Lord, Gop Kumar got the intimate personal service to fan the Lord with a chamara.
过了一段时间之后，由于主的仁慈，戈巴库马尔就有了可以亲手为主扇拂尘，用拂尘为主服务的机会。
So at that time, Gop Kumar could constantly feel the bliss of seeing the Lord.
那时戈巴库马尔就感受到恒常看见主的极乐。
And we know before he played the flute for the Lord.
我们知道在此之前他曾经为主吹笛子。
In the beginning, Gop Kumar could only see Lord Narayan very briefly in the audience. The Lord of Vaikuntha would not speak to Gop Kumar.
一开始，戈帕库马尔只能短暂的看见主拿案呢。Sorry, Mar, the second sentence. Can you repeat?
Well, Gop Kumar was fanning the Lord, and he's feeling the bliss of seeing the Lord, and he's playing on the flute for the Lord. But in the beginning, he could only see the Lord only very briefly, only got to see the Lord very briefly in the beginning.
过了段时间呢，哥帕库马尔他就可以为用查马尔浮尘为主扇凉，他也为主吹笛子，但是一开始他只能很短暂的看到主。
But after he got his initial training, then he was allowed a more regular service at the side of the Lord.
但是当他受过训练之后，他就被允许可以有规律的待在主的身边。
So he got that opportunity. It wasn't because of his own qualification, but it was by the mercy of the Lord.
他之所以有这种机会，并不是因为他有什么资格，这只是由于主的仁慈。
Mm. Not only was he an expert flute player, but Gop Kumar had the rare privilege.
他
有着极少的机会去娱乐主 entertain Lord Narayan.
哥帕库马尔得到了去娱乐主拿让的罕见的机会。
And he got this opportunity because he was such an expert flute player.
他之所以有这种罕有的机会，是因为他是一个精湛的吹竹笛的乐手。
So, because he had the habit in the past, over and over again, he would sometimes loudly chant different ways. He would call out, "Oh Krishna, Gopala." He would do it because he had the habit to do that in the past.
由于他过去的习惯，他会高声的呼喊 "Oh Krishna, Oh Gopala."他之所以这样做，是因为他过去有这种习惯。
So these two names of the Lord, the two names, Krishna and Gopala, they were very dear to Gop Kumar.
这两个名字 ,Krishna 和 Gopala, 是 Gopa Kumar 非常喜欢的名字。
So he found many different ways in which he could chant these names.
Gopa Kumar 就找出种种方法来唱诵这些名字。
So Gop Kumar was enjoying life in Vaikuntha.
Gopa Kumar 就这样在白昆塔享受着生活。
But he was also preparing himself to go on to a higher destination.
但是与此同时，他也做好准备来继续到更高的目的地。
And there was a seed of discontent which was growing in him with living in Vaikuntha.
在他的内心就有一颗不满的种子在生长，即便他现在居住在瓦昆塔。
So Gop Kumar, he had the habit of singing out loud. And he would sing different prayers of his own, of the Lord's activities in Gokula.
多帕库马尔习惯于高声的来唱出祷文，而这些祷文是讲的赞美着主在狗哭了的活动。
So of course, the Lord's pastimes in Gokula, this is his highest, the greatest glory of the Lord.
当然，主在Gokula的活动消时光是主的最高的、最伟大的荣耀。
So he was actually the, all of the different performances of Sankirtan, Gopkumar, was revealing these different pastimes of Gokumar, he described that the Lord's own by doing Sankirtan, but because Gokumar was doing Sankirtan, so he was actually describing Krishna's pastimes in Gokula. He was describing them to Lord Narayan.
通过他从事 Gopakumar 通过从事 Sankirtan, 就像主 Narayan 描绘了 Krishna 在 Gokula 的消时光。
So all the people in the Vaikuntha, they saw Gokumar doing like that. They were laughing, and they felt some affection for him. And they would often come to Gokumar and try to try to comfort him.
Vaikuntha, 无忧心思的人们，当他们看到这一幕场景的时候，他们会哈哈大笑，他们就会升起对 Gopakumar 的爱意，他们会来到 Gopakumar 面前安慰他。
And they would also, they would speak to Gopkumar and they would speak to him like teachers, like a teacher would instruct a student. And they would tell Gopkumar what he should do and what he shouldn't do.
他们会像老师教导学生一样对他说话，告诉他应该做什么，不应该做什么。
The residents of Vaikuntha, they would say to Gokumar, you should not speak to the Lord as, you should not speak to him as you should know that Lord Narayan Lord Narayan is going to They told Gokumar, you should not speak to the Lord with so much familiarity. You should be more respectful when you speak to him.
他们就对 Gopakumar 说，你跟主说话的时候不应该 有这么亲密的，是这样熟悉的，以这种熟悉的口吻跟主说话，你应该毕恭毕敬的跟主谈话。
And they told Gopkumar, you should just recite the standard prayers about his unlimited amazing glories. You don't have to recite the way you're doing it. Just say the standard prayers, which we all say.
他们对 Gopkumar 说，你只需要去背诵那些标准的祷文来赞美主的无限，主的不可思议就好了。你不要按照你的方式去来赞美主，你要像我们所说的所说出的祷文那样来背诵这些祷文。
And the Vaikuntha devotees, they did not like Gopkumar to address Lord Narayan with too much familiarity.
Vaikuntha 的人们不喜欢 Gopkumar 是以这样熟悉的口吻来对主说话，称呼主。
Gopkumar would just talk to the Lord. He'd say, "My dear Krishna and hey Gopala." But they did not like to hear Gopkumar talk to the Lord like that.
Gopkumar 就会对主说话的时候就会称呼他亲爱的 Krishna, hey Gopala, 但是Vaikuntha 无忧星宿的人们不喜欢听 Gopkumar 对主这样讲话。
They didn't like Gopkumar to address the Lord by any name. They felt uncomfortable hearing songs that focused on the Lord's childhood pastime.
他们不喜欢听Gopkumar 以任何方式来称呼主，他们就会感到不舒服。他们也不想听那些专注聚焦在主的孩提时代逍遥时光的歌曲。
Alright, so they wanted to hear Gopkumar glorify the Lord the way they do it in Vaikuntha.
他们希望听到 Gopkumar 像他们那样以他们的方式在 Vaikuntha 来荣耀主。
Just like they say, to annihilate the wicked and protect the civilized.
就像他们所说的，为了毁灭那些邪恶之徒，为了保护文明之士，文明人士。
And they also glorify Krishna by saying that you cheat Kamsa. And you disguise yourself as a cowherd boy by your illusory energy.
这些对主 Krishna 的荣耀包括你欺骗了 Kamsa, 你把自己伪装成一位牧牛童，你以你的虚幻能量 将自己伪装成一位牧牛童。
So the people in Vaikuntha, they think that Krishna only pretends to be a cowherd boy. But in actual fact, The people in Vaikuntha think Krishna is only pretending to be a cowherd boy.
Vaikuntha 的人们以为 Krishna 只是假装做一个牧牛童的样子。
And he is doing like that because he wants to cheat King Kamsa, because King Kamsa is maybe looking for him, want to kill him.
他之所以把自己假扮成一个牧牛童，是为了欺骗康萨，因为康萨在寻找他。
So these different Vaikuntha people, they tried to cheat Kamsa. No, the Vaikuntha people, they know that Krishna is only pretending to be a cowherd. Vaikuntha Basis.
Vaikuntha 的居民就以为 Krishna 只是假装做一个牧牛童。
Yeah, Krishna had to cheat Kamsa to get rid of the demons, like Putana.
Krishna 必须要欺骗 Kamsa 来铲除像 Putana 这样的女巫。
So, but there are people like Putana also, Krishna has to protect the cowherd men from people like Putana.
Krishna 也必须保护那些牧牛郎免受像 Putana 女巫这样的骚扰。
But the people who follow Gop Kumar, they believe that the Supreme Lord of all lords is never actually a degraded creature as a cowherd.
但是那些追随哥帕库马尔的人确信
Krishna wants to protect honest people like Vasudev.
Krishna 希望保护像 Vasudeva 这样的诚实之人。
And the people who are advising Gop Kumar, they believe that the Supreme Lord could never be a cowherd boy.
那些给 Gop Kumar 提建议的人们，他们相信至尊主不可能只是一个区区的牧牛童而已。
Okay. So, Gop Kumar. Okay, we'll stop there today.
那我们今天就讲到这里，我们来看一下上礼拜的问题。第一个问题是来自于 Kamala Murthy， 尊敬的 Guru， 顶半年的莲花族，请问如果有时候接触到一些物质层面的灵魂和非奉献者的灵魂，应该怎么样更好的和他们相处？或者是远离他们。Kamalamurthy Mataji said, "Dear Guru, obeisance to your lotus feet. May I ask? Sometimes I got in contact with some souls who are on the material platform and some non-devotees. So may I ask, how can I?" Get along with them.
Well,
better. Or should I keep some distance, keep away from them?
Well, you have to consider why they're associating with you. What do they want? Are they willing to hear about Krishna consciousness for you? Or are they not interested in anything spiritual?
这时候你要考虑他们为什么要跟你联谊，他们想要什么，他们是想从你这里聆听 Krishna 知觉，还是他们对于灵性的话题不感兴趣。
if they're not interested in Krishna consciousness, then you don't need to spend much time with them.
如果他们对于 Krishna 知觉不感兴趣，你就不需要和他们花很多时间在一起。好。
But if they're interested in Krishna consciousness, then you can chant together, and you can have some kirtan. You can do some kirtan together.And you can read Prabhupada's books together, and you can discuss with them.
如果他们感兴趣，你就可以跟他们花时间，跟他们一起念诵、kirtan， 一起读帕帕德的书，一起讨论。Thank you. 下一个问题是来自于 Chaitanya Mangala Devi Dasi。顶拜孤类，顶拜翻译及所有奉献者，在百昆塔，一切都是主的，一切都用于服务主。我的问题是，物质世界的一切也是主的，我们如何一切都服务于主？内心没有拥有之念，理论上明白，实际上不容易做到。谢谢孤鲁。Obeisance to Guru and all devotees.In Vaikuntha, everything belongs to the Lord, and everything is used in the service of the Lord. My question is that, since everything in the material world also belongs to the Lord, how can we use everything in the service of the Lord, but at the same time, there is no sense of proprietorship in our hearts, although I know,We know that in theory, but in actual, but in practice, it's not easy to do that. Thank you, Guru.
I haven't understood the question.
The question is that, she's asking.Although we know that everything belongs to the Lord and everything should be used in the service, and
yes.
we do Nothing belongs to us. We know this, but we cannot carry it out in our practical life.
Well, the principle is to try to use it in Krishna's service. So you have some money, you use it to buy food, and you offer the food to Krishna. And you need somewhere to live, so you have to pay rent. You use your money to pay the rent, and you think of your home as a temple, and you put Krishna's picture there, and you worship Krishna, and you think of your home as a temple. And whatever money you have, it belongs to Krishna. You try to use it for Krishna.
你可以把钱用来购买食物，把食物供奉给Krishna，你还需要一个居所，你应该付房租，你把你的家变成一所庙宇，你在家中安放Krishna的照片，崇拜Krishna，你把家变成一所庙，因为你的钱属于Krishna，所以你就把你的钱花在Krishna身上。
Right?
是这样吗?
Everything belongs to Krishna. So your body also belongs to Krishna. So you should use your body to serve Krishna.
人万事万物都属于Krishna, 连你的身体、你的躯体也是属于Krishna的, 所以你应该把你的身体用来服务Krishna。 And her question seems that how to realize that we possess nothing, that everything loves Krishna.
Well, just think about it carefully. When you were born, you came into this world with nothing in your hands. And when you die, you'll leave everything behind.
所以请你考虑这一点，就当你出生的时候，你是一无所有的，你两手空空来到这个世上，而当你死亡的时候，你也要把一切都留在身后。 Yes. Next one.
Yes.
Okay. 下一个问题来自于哲明。 礼拜尊敬的女士和奉献者们，关于主的莲花族的疑问，实际上我看了《Chaitanya传》，根据描述，Rukmini王后尤其强调 Krishna 的莲花族的吸引力胜过了他本人对他的吸引力。我总想 Krishna 的莲花族有什么特别的？为什么是莲花族而不是莲花手或莲花脸？
Because we begin the meditation from the feet. The feet begin from the feet. It's more humble. And we need to cultivate humility.
因为当我冥想的时候，是从莲花族开始冥想的，我们需要培养谦卑。The next one is， 下个问题是来自于何家权，顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和奉献者家人。在百昆塔的每个生物都拥有自己的富裕，富裕外显时他们不骄傲，内藏时内藏外显时不骄傲，也就是说不做服务时富裕隐藏，做服务富裕便显现出来吗？In my Kunta, everyone has opulence. When the opulence is, when there are opulence, they are not proud of the opulence. When the opulence is hidden, What this question? 就不做富裕，这个问题好像不是特别看不太懂。不做富裕 ？Can I understand that if they don't do service, the opulence is hidden? If they do service,The opulence is visible.
So, what's the question?
He wants to confirm the understanding, whether understanding is right.
Yes.
是的，您的理解是正确的。下一个问题是 Star， 你卖孤儿帮牛能不能当神一样去崇拜？如果把你当神崇拜，这也是把你当神崇拜，这也是冒犯，对吗？Obeisance Guru， Can we worship the cows as God？As God,
no.
If, 我们不能把牛当神一样崇拜。下一个问题 ，Krishna Priya， Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru Maharaj。和奉献者，我的问题是：一，邀请家人读书，他有时候不愿意，说喜欢一个人看书。加入的时候跟完成任务一样，读不了多久就说行了吧。这种情况还要叫他一起读吗？还是我自己读书就行了？其他服务也类似，我自己做。不用管他要不要做，还是鼓励他，该是怎么方式呢？So my question is that, I invited my family member to read books with me. He is not willing. He said he likes to read by himself. When he read with me,He seems to carry that it out of duty and only read only a short time. So my question is that under the circumstances, shall I request him to read along with me, read the books with me? 我属
Yes.
来。You mean that she just read by herself?
No, she should read with her spouse.
Okay. 那你还是应该，姑姑说你还是应该叫上她一起读书。
And discuss. You don't just read, but you discuss together. And you explain what you're reading. And if you don't understand something, you question about it.
Hare Krishna. Guru Maharaj, Keshava Priya, 后来他说这个问题，他已经就是解答了，就不用再回答，解决了，对。
好，那就没有问题了。
上面漏了一个问题，就是有一个新的奉献者问，如果把 guru 当神崇拜，是不是冒犯？
Well, if we worship guru as God, is it an offense?
That's
we
my
worship
body. That's my body.
这是 Mayavadi 假象中的做法。
But we worship the guru as the representative of God.
我们把 guru 当成神的代表崇拜。
And whatever we offer to him, he will offer to God.
无论我们向 guru 供奉什么， guru 都会把他供奉给神。That's all questions, Maharaj.
Okay. Then we'll stop here. Thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you, Maharaj.
Dhanshir Guru, Dhanshir Padmamukhi, Dhanshir Sati, Dhanshir Sura from Shenzhen Lingping, Chufun Niman, Changchong Kwaila, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
是，百坤特知音服务园聆听，非常非常感谢圣 Bhakti Vinashna Singh Amara 给我们带来的精彩的早课，谢谢 Padmukhi 的主持，感谢所有奉献者的聆听，那我们下周同一时间再见，Hare Krishna。